In this video, we're going to talk about what happens when disease alleles are found on the X chromosome and how that affects patterns of inheritance. So what happens when disease genes are found on the sex chromosomes? Well, it turns out that the patterns of inheritance will be a little different for those traits compared to genes that are on the autosomes. So let's talk about the sex chromosomes. They determine the inheritance of certain traits. They are designated as X and Y in humans and a few other animals as well. Most mammals use XY sex determination, as do fruit flies and some other invertebrates. Birds, on the other hand, have a different method of sex determination, and reptiles are even different still. In humans, these sex chromosomes determine an individual's biological sex. In humans, males are the heterogametic sex. Now this term, it sounds similar to heterozygous, but it is different. The heterogametic sex means that males produce two different types of sperm cells, one that has an X chromosome in it, and one that has a Y chromosome in it. Typically, the egg will always have one X chromosome in it. So because of this, it's the male gamete which determines the sex of an offspring. Nothing can be done after that point of fertilization to affect the sex of the human embryo, as in behaviors or actions or certain things that you do to try to influence whether it will be a male or a female offspring. In essence, the sex has been determined at that time of fertilization. So here we see a son will receive a sperm cell with a Y chromosome in it from the father and an egg cell with an X chromosome from the mother, whereas a daughter will receive a sperm cell with an X chromosome and an egg cell with an X chromosome. Now it turns out that there are a lot of genes on the X chromosome, not just those that affect sex-specific features. And so we call these genes X-linked genes. So X-linked genes are any genes that are located on that X chromosome. It actually turns out that majority of these genes have nothing to do with sex at all. They were first discovered during studies on fruit flies. Now what had happened is that these fruit fly researchers suddenly saw a fruit fly that had bright white eyes, which is very different than the red eyes that most fruit flies normally have. When they caught this fruit fly that had white eyes, they found that it was a male fruit fly. So they crossed it to a female fruit fly that had red eyes, and all of the offspring had red eyes. This didn't seem too out of the ordinary. They just thought that red eyes were dominant to white eyes. So they allowed those offspring to cross-fertilize and to look at the F2 generation. In the F2 generation, the white eyes showed up consistently in about one quarter of the offspring, which is what they expected. Yet, as they looked a little closer, every fruit fly that had white eyes was also male. Now this is different than what they had seen in other traits, and so this actually told the researchers that the gene involved here was found on the X chromosome. Now why is it that males are more likely to show recessive traits that are found on the X chromosome? Well, it's due to the fact that males have only one X chromosome, whereas females have two. So let's look at these inheritance patterns. There are three chemical symbols that I would like to introduce you to that are used in this genetic cross. There's X capital R. This is going to be an X chromosome. With a red eye color allele. Compared to X little r, this is going to be an X chromosome with a white eye color allele. And then lastly, we have Y, which is a Y chromosome. which doesn't have an eye color allele. And so we started with a male fruit fly with white eyes. It's X little r y, crossed to a female fruit fly with normal red eyes. And we look at their offspring. All of their offspring have red eyes. But something to note is that the females are now carriers for this white eye color allele. They have red eyes, but they're also carrying the white eye allele. Now, if these females are then crossed to a male with normal red eyes, and we look at their offspring, the male can make two types of gametes, the female can make two types of gametes, X with a capital R and X with a lowercase r. All of the daughters will receive an X chromosome from both the father and the mother. And in this case, all of the daughters will have red eyes because they receive at least one copy of X capital R. When we look at the sons receive their Y chromosome from their dad and their X chromosome from their mother. Since there are two possible options that the mother could provide, we see that half of the sons will have red eyes, half of the sons will have white eyes. Now, is it possible to have a female with white eyes? The answer is yes, but the mother has to at least be a carrier, and the father has to have white eyes. If this is the case, it is possible for the female to receive two copies of the X little r allele, but her father would have to have the trait, and her mother would have to be a carrier. This is why X-linked disorders are seen more often in males than in females. Males have only one X chromosome. If the mother is a carrier, she will not be affected herself, but 50% of sons from carrier mothers would likely be affected. Now, females rarely get these diseases because they must receive two affected X chromosomes, one from each parent. Now, what are some human diseases or disorders that are sex-linked? Well, one is red-green colorblindness. So there are a number of genetic conditions which result from sex-linked or X-linked genes. Red-green colorblindness is one of them. It is categorized by a malfunctioning of the light-sensitive cells in the eyes. Personally, I've known many individuals who have had red-green colorblindness, and of those who I know of, the vast majority of them have been male. I've only met one female who was red-green colorblind, and it's true that her father was red-green colorblind, and her maternal grandfather had also been red-green colorblind. Now, a more serious genetic disease or disorder is hemophilia. A blood clotting disease. Now, especially in the past, we didn't have effective ways to treat hemophilia. These individuals would often die very early in life. It showed up much more often in males than in females because it was a sex-linked trait. Here we look at the family pedigree of Tsar Nicholas II of Russia. He and his wife Alexandra had a son, Alexis, who had hemophilia. Now, Tsar Nicholas did not have hemophilia, so the source had to have been Alexandra. When we look at Alexandra's parents, her father did not have hemophilia, and so her mother must have been the carrier. When we look at her mother, Queen Victoria, Prince Albert of England, Prince Albert did not have hemophilia. So again, we know that it had to have been Queen Victoria who was the carrier for this recessive disorder. Four generations of this family tree, the only time that the disease actually showed up was when a son had received the affected X chromosome. This is why sex-linked genes have different patterns of inheritance than autosomal genes. In our next video, we'll talk about genetic diseases and disorders that are caused by chromosomal abnormalities.